Welcome to Voice It with me, Karishma. Today is a very special episode and we have someone very, very fun today also. So the topic today is extremely super exciting. It's because I've noticed this with, you know, the journey of my career as well. I've noticed few things that make or break some people. And today we have, you know, the beautiful Mrs. Shraddha Agarwal with us. She's a success coach. She helps numerous women, you know, stand on their own feet, help them with, you know, empowering them and helping them to start whatever, you know, project that they would like, entrepreneurship projects, also self-image, self-management projects. So, you know, it's such a big, nice pleasure to have you here, Mr. Shraddha, today. Thank you for being a part of this conversation. And we have some very interesting questions today, which have been asked to us by audiences. And, you know, we just want you to, like, you know, share all your beautiful insight with us today.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Karishma, for this platform. And I'm sure you're helping a lot of people out there with this space that you've created and with this kind of broadcast and podcast. It's amazing and wonderful to know you also. And I'm looking forward to the session.
Thank you. Very kind of you. Thank you. So I would like to begin with our first very important question. First, I would like to tell everybody that our topic for today is something which so many people are a little confused about. Maybe some people don't have that kind of clarity on it. So, you know, you've been very kind today to elaborate on this topic. Our topic for today is image management for a successful life. Why is it that, you know, there are certain aspects of our image and the way that we project certain things about ourselves that actually end up helping us with that little bit of push that we need to lead a more successful, peaceful, or probably happier life at the end. So Shraddha, the first question for you is, you know, what are some of the external factors that actually affect us or affect a personality at the end of the day?
So for this, to answer this question, let us first know what is the personality that we are looking. What is it called personality? So our personality is all about us, the way we think, the way we have emotions and feelings, the thoughts and how we are behaving with the other people. So this contributes to our personality. Now, when we say that how does the external factors contribute to the making of our personality, it has a very important and a big role, I must say that. Yes. As external factors, I would say now, it's all about the environment. Now, environment plays a very important role in our upbringing, from where we come from, the place we come from, the location, geographic conditions, city, town, India, abroad, wherever in the world we are, our environment plays a very important impact. Also, the social environment, I would say the cultural backgrounds that we all come from, different backgrounds that we come from, they play an important role. Not to forget our school life, our college life. So these are usually the environments we see in our world when we are growing up till the end. So from upcoming from our home environment to the school, to colleges, to also to the social world that we are outside. Now, in this social world, we should not forget the social media also. Now, what happens when we are connected to people via social media? And of course, today it's only through social media. Most of us know each other. We get to know each other. Yeah. How we portray ourselves or how we actually look at the social media or the environment around us, how they have molded us to become as a personality. It affects us because the conditioning is happening in such a way that, for example, you have a household with a lot of values and, you know, they have their own restrictions, or there are open households that do not stop the children from moving out. So there are two different aspects to this. So the personalities that would be coming out of both these households would be very different. One will be a kind of an outgoing person. The other could be a possible that he or she is the one who likes to stay inside, could be an introvert person, unable to express the views because she's not got that kind of an environment and the upbringing. So thus, environment in all these aspects, from our teachers to our friends, to our peers, to our colleagues, to our parents, to our siblings, to our relatives, to the people with whom we are connected over the media, all of these play an important role in the environment. And what does it do to our environment? It can enhance us or to a personality, sorry. It can enhance our personality in a good and a better way, or it can actually can also demotivate us for certain things. So as and when we go, probably in the session, I will be able to give you more answers. How do they affect us as a personality?
Yes, thank you. Thank you for that elaboration. I think everything that you said makes so much sense, because at the end of the day, every single action that we do is somewhere down the line a result of the environment that we come from, because that's the kind of, you know, if we're a plant, that's the kind of garden that we've got. So we automatically, you know, reflect around with whatever it is that has been fed to us to grow then. So I think it's what you said makes so much sense. You mentioned this thing that, you know, the way on social media that we communicate to people, you know, we end up meeting so many people. So, you know, I have realized that there are two kinds of skills that we portray on any medium. It could be in a physical format, or it could be in something which is like a social media format. The verbal communication skills and our non-verbal communication skills. So, you know, I would like you to elaborate on how can people enhance their non-verbal communication skills to be able to be more successful?
Okay, so for that, first let us understand what are non-verbal communication. What are the modes of non-verbal? Because when we say non-verbal communication, there are different aspects to this. It's just not about one thing, that if you are quiet and you're speaking, but there is a lot that is going on around. So I will give you a small, let's take a situation. Like there is a room full of people, and you are probably sitting in one, you are one of the audience over there, and suddenly the door opens and there is a personality or a person enters the room. You, what happens to you when you just have a glance at that person at that particular time? What do you think about, or what goes on in your mind? Can you just tell me?
I think number one would be the, you know, the kind of manners that the person has, you know, are they very vigilant about the fact that they're in a room with a lot of people, or are they very self-absorbed? So that's one of the things. And the second thing would be obviously their, you know, physical representation, the way that, you know, they are behaving themselves. I think behavior is something which people notice the first thing about somebody.
Exactly. You are to the point, Karishma. So what happens whenever somebody enters a room, we actually judge the person unconsciously. It's not in our conscious that, okay, I have to judge, but we just do that very unconsciously. So what are the different aspects that we look into the person? As you said, behavior is one of the things, the way the person is carrying herself or himself, how is he meeting other people over there, the way he is, you know, dressed up. That is first thing that comes to a glance, you know, what is he wearing? The kind of grooming, is he groomed well properly? How is he walking? The body language of the person over there. So these are the elements that we first see without even that person telling us a hi or a hello. Yeah. And the moment that we see, these are the important elements of image that we call. So it's an aspect external, the non-verbal communication, which it comprises of your clothing, your accessories with your clothing, your manners, your behavior, and your body language. So these are very three important aspects, which we call as a visual resume. Okay. Now, without even speaking to the person, you have told the person about you a lot through your visual communication, because the person is telling you about from where does he come from, what kind of a background it could be, the values and attitude of the person is seen in the way he is moving around, he is carrying himself, and the kind of clothes that the person is wearing. So these are three important aspects of the non-verbal communication that we speak today. And through this, we are communicating about ourselves to the other person, I would say just flowingly, you know, it just flows through it, because you don't have to ask the person. And in that very moment, we decide whether I should be talking to that person or no. Yes. Has not that happened many a times? You know, we decide,
absolutely,
oh, the person looks very interesting, I must have a conversation with the person. So to get through into more details about the person, we take the decision there and then. Otherwise, we also get put off with certain people because they don't look so attractive. They don't look so pleasing. But the personality is not that pleasing that we even feel like speaking to that person. Yes. Now, why does why is it so important? We would say, people say, you know, that first impressions, last impressions. I would say these are the lasting impressions, basically. And it takes time to change this impression. Now, this usually happens on the new person that you with a new person or a stranger, where we are trying to create an impression in different situations. Could be your public appearance, could be your interview skills, could be your you're going for a job, or anywhere you're moving in a new place, people judge you. They are there, you are creating an impression with them completely. So they are looking at these aspects of to create an impression about you. And these can be changed. I would not say that they are not, his first impression is the last impression, does not really stand anymore, because a person can change that lasting impression. Yeah. However, the person should get that opportunity to change that impression by meeting the person again and again. That's how after 5-10 meetings, we do change views about the people also we met. You know, first time I met the person, he was not that appropriate, did not sound so confident. But as I moved ahead, I felt that, no, there is something in the person. There is a different kind of a charm. So it is affecting our personality. These are the factors how people have looked at us. So we are either feeling very confident about ourselves, or, you know, when we carry a positive confidence in us, it shows, it reflects in our personality.
Absolutely. Yes.
So that's what is the nonverbal communication that we talk about, these three important aspects.
Thank you for, you know, so one of the things which I am so grateful for you to say all these things for is because so many people, you know, when girls, boys, when they, you know, come into this age group where they go in for interviews, they go to meet professional people, you know, there is always this little bit of lack of judgment where they feel that, you know, when our resume is there, our educational profile is there, right? That is enough to be able to kind of land us something. But I've always seen that recruiters, you know, company professionals, bosses, however you would like to call them, they always kind of have a more higher preference looking at their non-verbal communication skills rather than looking at just their resume. So I think all the points that you said are so vital, so important for any teenager, adolescent, or any young adult trying to, you know, get into a sphere where they are looking for probably, you know, getting better at the work that they want, getting in new places, new companies, if they would like to enter those things, or just, you know, creating a good networking space for themselves. I think all the beautiful points you mentioned are so important for every single boy and girl today to be able to understand why it is so important. Because, you know, Shraddha, I've noticed that they just have this thing where it's in the background. They forget about these things. They forget about the appearance, the manners, the poise, the little bit of, you know, patience. All these kinds of things are so playing in the background. But this is something where it needs to now come in the forefront, along with your credentials, along with, you know, the kind of resume that you have as far as your academics or your work is concerned. So thank you for, you know, explaining these points.
Also, to add to this, Karishma, it's not about that, you know, we've usually seen now when you have to go for an interview for a job, what they will do at the last moment, they will, one day prior, they will now decide, what am I going to wear? How am I going to behave? What are my manners? How am I going to sit? So they just do that a day prior. Most of them will do that a day prior. Now, in a day, you are not going to inculcate in that in you. So that habit has to be there. So the moment we start having those habits, every day we dress up ourselves nicely, we behave properly, we have the positive body language, the communication, if we are doing it on a regular basis, you don't need to pretend on the final day of your interview. Yes. It is in you, it is in your blood to behave like this. And the recruiter will automatically know that this person is confident and is just not a practice of one day, because then you hesitate, you are, you know, murmuring, you don't know what to do now, you're trying to remember, how am I supposed to behave? So all those uncomfortable situations are arising then. But if it is in you, if you start doing it prior, it is just with you all the time, that wherever you go, it's with you all the time.
Yes, fantastic, fantastic point. The way, you know, when I do a consultation with a client, the way that, you know, it's so important to understand, and I make it a point that I convey this message to them, that it's a lifestyle change that we're doing over here to be able to create a sustainable pattern for you. So the same thing that you beautifully put right now, that all these things that you just spoke about and all the things that we are going to be speaking about should be a part inculcated in you. So that at the end of the day, it's a natural practice for you. And it's not something that you are just putting up or imitating for a little bit of time, because then it's not going to help any which ways.
Yes. Absolutely.
Shraddha, coming to the next part, you know, you mentioned the image management, the physical appearance, you know, the the non-verbal communication aspect you mentioned. Can you tell us, you know, in brief, some core principles of how it is that someone can adapt some of these points that you just mentioned now to be able to be more confident and to be able to have a better self-image?
So when we talk about image management or self-image, so self-image is about how you look at yourself. You know, it includes your body image as well as your personality, your traits, your values, everything. It's a combination. So as a person, you present to the other person. So when we have a positive self-image, when we have positive thoughts about our own body, when we are comfortable with our own body, we are on a higher level, at a higher level completely. That makes us so comfortable that whenever we deal with other people, we are in a space where we find ourselves more credible, valuable, and, you know, authority that we want to build towards our own image. It's always there with us. So a self-positive self-image becomes a very important aspect. As far as image management is concerned, now we have seen people doing their financial management. They are coming, health management is also a quite interesting topic these days, as you know. And, you know, people are coming with, they are coming with home management. They have their, I don't know, different time management, everything they want to manage. Yes. But tell me, how many of us are really thinking about managing our wardrobes, managing our clothes? Yes. And how many of us, I'm going to speak so, I'm going to be a little outspoken here and tell you, how many of us go without clothes outside even our room? So that is so important that the clothes that you wear on your body becomes a prime aspect for your image. The moment you wear good clothes, the moment you wear the clothes that give you confidence, you are presenting a new you to the world. It's completely new. So we must not take clothes for granted. Hum kehte hai, we say roti, kapda aur makan. Three things, you know.
Yes.
Clothes, food and house, shelter. But food and shelter is what we look forward. Everybody is running about that I have to feed my family, I have to have a home for my family. But what about the clothes?
Absolutely.
We just randomly choose our clothes and those clothes are not giving the kind of productivity levels that we look in a person. It's not taking us anywhere if we are not giving importance to our clothes. So clothing management or image, which is formed with your clothes, become an important aspect. So image management is a continuous process. It's not that if you just do it once, it's there for you lifelong. How health is also a continuous process. So I would say health and your own image, it's so important to manage them together. It's a lifestyle change, complete lifestyle change. You have to adopt it. It's a continuous process because you're making an impact of that image on you first.
Absolutely.
And then on the others. Because we say the way we dress affects the way we think. Our thinking changes completely.
Changes.
You wear good clothes, you feel good, you know. You'll stand straight, you will be completely powerful look that comes into you. That's how you're feeling inside, right? Those clothes give you that power. And valuable think inside. And that's how you're going to behave with the people outside.
Absolutely.
If you are behaving in a perfect and in a very powerful manner, so confident, people are going to respond to you in a similar way.
Yes.
And if you are very lazy about your own self, people are going to respond to you in the same way. So image management also helps us to set boundaries for the people, how they are going to treat us.
Fantastic.
We are setting a boundary for them.
Yes.
The way we are going to present, it is telling them, this is the way I need to be treated.
Absolutely.
This is what we want. That is
I cannot agree more. Absolutely. I was just saying that I cannot agree more with, you know, the wise words of wisdom that you have just told us, because I personally relate to every single thing that you said today. It's beautiful how just one change brings about such a big mindset shift also within ourselves. Thank you for elaborating on this point and beautifully explaining it the way that you did. Thank you.
And, you know, we talk about image and clothes as the external appearance, Karishma, but it plays on your mind.
Yes.
Every time, I'm sure everyone who's watching this, who's listening to this, will agree to this, that images, the clothes are the external appearance of who you are inside. The yes. day you feel excited, the way the day you are very happy, automatically you pick out clothes that will make you feel more happier. The day you feel dull, the day you feel drowned and, you know, no energy in you, the colors that you pick up, the kind of clothes yes. that you pick up, they will yes. all be like that.
Fantastic. I was actually thinking of the same thing that you mentioned right now, that the colors play such a big role in our psyche. You know, we'll automatically gravitate towards something which is a little dull when we are not in that state of mind where we would want to pick up something nice, fresh, bright. We'll automatically end up picking up something where we are like, it's okay to just blend into something right now. I do not want to stand out. You know how it just plays with our psyche at this point. Thank you for bringing that out. On this note, Shraddha, I also want to say something wherein, you know, I've noticed, this is one thing which you would have noticed a lot as well, you know, as women. Especially women, they try to choose the color black so much because they want to, obviously, you know, there is a self-image where they would want to portray to be more slimmer and, you know, the black color does that to you. So that's one aspect. And the second thing is that, you know, the color black also has this thing where it gives you that power to just be a little in the background for a while. People don't really notice you so much if you end up wearing black. I've had a personal, you know, account of this. But that plays such a big role on our psyche. The days that we end up wearing black, if we just go back and we start thinking, it plays with our psychology. We end up not wanting to do certain things because of the way that we are looking or because of the colors that we are wearing. I'm sure you must have noticed this too, but I feel like the reduction for women especially, I think the reduction of wearing the black color and wearing more positive, bright and, you know, vibrant colors, if I may put it, helps so much with their own confidence levels.
Absolutely. See, the women have this mindset that if I'm wearing a black, I'll look slim.
Yes.
That's the main thing. That is the reason the women want to wear the color black.
Absolutely.
Whether you're wherever they want to be, just, you know, hide themselves. So in the color black. But then there are other ways also.
Yes.
So if somebody gets to know, I mean, I can tell someone to wear a white color and still the person will look so attractive and beautiful. So there are ways to wear the colors. It's not about just colors. It's about the thought. So, of course, as you said, you know, and also the connections are there, you know, black to be worn in the night, white to be worn in the day. This is to be worn in the evening. This is to be worn in the summer. This is to be worn in the winter. In fact, to many of my clients, I tell them when the day is dull, wear some brighter colors rather than going in for grays and browns and blacks. Wear some brighter colors. Give some positivity outside, you know.
Yes.
So you should feel positive. People around you should feel so happy and positive that you're spreading that charm and aura everywhere around you, that positive thing. We are looking for that positivity everywhere. There's so much of depression. There is so much of sadness. But we need this positivity. So the colors are the thing that can give life to anything. So always have that positive vibes around you with colors.
Fantastic. Thank you. So just to sum it up, the core principles, you know, that you spoke about, you know, briefly, one would be our, you know, choice and attention towards the kind of clothing that we are wearing. The second would be the colors, you know, bringing more positive colors into your wardrobe, right? So thank you for shedding light on both these four principles. Shraddha, also another thing that I want to ask you is that we spoke about all these things. Can you help us with understanding why is it so important for us that we should have a nice self-image? Leaving everything aside, why is it that we should be consciously working towards improving our self-image day by day by day?
So as we spoke, what does a self-image do and what does a person who does not have a self-image? You know, we are brought up as kids and as I said, the conditioning, the environment plays an important role. And when we are child, we don't know about ourselves. We have never seen that, you know, this is not right or that is not right. But the people around us have told us, oh, you are short, you have a big nose, you have a dark skin, you have the color of your eyes is very different, you don't have a good height, you are on a healthier side or fat. Literally, we've heard that you're so fat, and the people who are thin, they've heard that you're so thin. I mean, so just tell me, who is happy with these kind of comments?
Nobody.
And we have not labeled ourselves like that. We have heard these from people. And so we try and now we go in front of the mirror and we look at all those negative aspects what people have told us about ourselves, and we start believing in that. Now what happens when we start believing in that? We find that we don't find ourselves attractive at all, because we see that, you know, we want to be people pleasers, right? People should be happy around me when I am there with them.
Yes.
So in that sense, we forget that how to please ourselves. We stop loving ourselves. We stop taking care of ourselves. We try to please people. So we try to do 10 different things for 10 different people. But believe me, who is happier in that? Those 10 people are also not happy, because it keeps on changing with people and everybody around us. So the final thing is that gives us depression. Okay, that gives us low confidence. Our self-esteem also is like absolutely zero. Yes. Nothing around us seems to be good. We are fighting to get that perfect figure, whether it is a zero or whether it is a perfect 10. I don't know what is a perfect figure actually.
Yes.
So we are just striving for that. And the social media again has played a very important. I mean, it's just there everywhere. So people keep on editing the pictures. They will have the best of the pictures on there. And so these young children who are coming today, they want to have that perfect body, the beach body. They want to have the perfect skin, the perfect face. I don't know what is, everything is perfect, but we don't know the definition of perfect.
Perfect.
Where is the definition of perfect, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
I feel the definition of perfect is love the way who you are, accept your body the way it is.
Yes.
Those imperfections are unique to you. And that is what makes you special. If you have a big nose, be proud of that nose. Nobody else has that. Okay. It's me who has that big nose. If you're short height, you are good things come in small packages. So you are that. You have so much positivity inside you. So you are that kind of package. So we should give these positive talks to ourselves. Rather than going into negative emotions, we should have positive emotions. So I'm going to tell you how these are affecting us in this manner, and how can we even improve that, you know? So they are affecting us in all the way. It's just playing with our mind all the time. Our productivity level goes down completely, because you are just wanting to please people, and therefore you are working what they want and not what you really are. And what do you want with your life?
Yes.
In that context, we are leaving behind so many things that we could have done on the way back.
Yes.
And there we are standing with nobody with us, even at that point of time. For the people who have with us, around us, for whom we have made this body, created this, all good things about us, went to the cosmetologist, went to the surgeries, and all of these things people will do for that matter, because they want to look the best so that people will like them. But let me tell you, people do not like you for actually the way you look. They like you as a person who you are. So develop on that. Give more positive affirmations to yourself. Give that self-love. Take care of your body. Be health conscious, but don't be so much that you go into the deepest stage of, where you are getting so weak and all the conditions of your body are getting weaker and weaker day by day. Don't go into that. It's not about the weight. It's about how you look. And that image that you develop, the moment you accept your body, you are comfortable with your body, you will feel stronger in that.
Absolutely.
Because you know that nobody else can do that for you. It's only you can do that. You feel stronger. You are able to love your body and you feel you are more happier. Because whenever you accept things the way they are, you make it happy. See, the nature around us is it perfect? You see all sorts of, if you go in a garden or a forest, you see all sorts of trees, leaves, thick, thin, cut, they will be small, they will be big, they will be long, they will be tall, they will be short. But we all love nature, right? Anybody you ask, they will say, I love nature. Just see the imperfections of nature. That's how they harmonize. That is the reason they are all together and look so beautiful and perfect together.
Yes.
If they were all just standard, we would have not liked them.
Yes.
Because of this uneven imperfections, we like it. That's how the people are. We are all imperfectly perfect in our own ways. And we need to accept the uniqueness of each other. That's how we will start loving each other and also loving the other person in front of you, rather than complaining, blaming, constantly doing that, and negativity, throwing negativity at the person. So we have to stop that. We have to stop complaining, blaming, and just be who you are and develop the confidence in you with the other things rather than what people are telling you. Do whatever you love to do and accept yourself completely and thoroughly and see the change that you will see within 10 days, I will say. The moment we accept ourselves, we are true to ourselves. That's how we are going to be happy with people also. And we get the strength and stamina to take those negative comments. If they give you, I know where they go from. Okay, it's absolutely fine. I'm this. Yes. I'm going to be like this. If you like me, I like you. If you don't like me, I don't like you.
Yes. I think so many things would be so much more easier if, you know, we had the simple philosophy that, you know, the last point that you mentioned that, you know, I will be and I will flow the way that I want to flow. I will work at myself to be a better person. And then after that, if somebody accepts me for what I am, it works. And if they do not like me or they do not accept me for what I am, we wish them well and we move ahead with our own life. I think that that one Absolutely. Principle changes so many things for us in the way that we communicate with people also, you know.
Yes.
All the points you mentioned were absolutely to the point with the fact that, you know, so many things you mentioned about body positivity also. So many young women and men also these days get affected by the small comments that people tell them. You know, Shraddha, I've noticed this one thing, and I think you must have noticed this way more than me, that, you know, when we meet somebody for the first time, there are a lot of people who, instead of saying anything to us in a more harmonious way, will initially comment on our external factor with a negative comment. You know, they'll be like, hi, how are you? And then they'll be like, oh, you've become so fat. Or they'll be like, oh, why is your skin breaking out? Or, you know, they will be like, oh, why have you become so tanned? So, you know, the first thing that somebody says to somebody when they meet them after a very long time, you know, and this is in context to relatives, friends, neighbors, any acquaintance, right? It could be just anybody. I think one thing that people need to really, really change is that, of course, work on your self-image, but also work on the fact that when you are communicating to somebody, please don't break somebody's confidence like that. Please don't do these things to somebody knowingly, unknowingly. Have a nice conversation with them. Instead of bringing up something negative, why not say something nice about them? Because you've seen them after so long,
Absolutely.
You know?
Yes,
if, instead of putting somebody on the spot and bringing out it's a negative connotation, you know? Why not say something nice to somebody? Or aapka din bhi achha hoga, uska din bhi achha hoga, fir aage saari achhi cheeze hogi.
वही होता है ना, एक अच्छी सोच से ही सब कुछ आगे अच्छा होता है. सो आई टेल देम, यू नो, वी मीट पीपल, टेल देम यू लुक सो ब्यूटीफुल, आई मीन इट्स लवली टू सी यू टुडे. सो दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ कॉन्वर्सेशंस पीपल वुड लाइक टू हैव विथ यू ऑल्सो. दैट्स हाउ वी बिल्ड गुड रिलेशनशिप्स. एट द एंड ऑफ ऑल, वी वॉन्ट टू बिल्ड गुड रिलेशनशिप्स विद पीपल, वेदर दे आर फैमिली, फ्रेंड्स, हूएवर दे आर. So we want to live in a world having nice thoughts about each other, bringing it up together, positive vibes, happiness, laughter, that's what. And through what the time we all have gone through, past 2 years almost, Absolutely. We know the value of that now.
Yes, yes.
We should realize that value now, that people are more important than anything else.
Anything else. Absolutely. Bingo. I completely agree with that. We spoke about this thing that, you know, people sometimes judge us. People look at ourselves, the external factor of ourselves. Shraddha, what I have noticed is that when somebody speaks to you and they start having a conversation with you, they usually have a conversation with you about the external factors, right? They will not comment initially on your personality. They will not comment on your behavior initially. They won't comment on these things, but they comment on your physical attributes. Now that sometimes induces a lot of anxiety in some people when they are confronted on the spot or they are spoken to about their body, about their skin, about their you know, factors which they are not very comfortable about, with their image, with their self-image, with their physical image. It induces on the spot anxiety with these people. Can you help us with some tips, you know, from your side, or any advice that you would like to give people who sometimes feel uncomfortable in social situations when they are confronted with, you know, comments about their physical attributes? How can they navigate this anxiety that they feel about their physical appearance?
So the most important thing is that we should not be feeling this anxiety. This happens only when we have not accepted our body the way it is. The moment we do that, of course, the person says that to us, it does not affect us. Oh, you've lost weight? Yes. Oh, you've gained weight? Yes. Don't I look good? Don't I look much more healthier? Isn't my skin glowing? I mean, so you have to be so positive and accepting your own self that the people will stop commenting you for all these aspects that they are seeking. When I go to a lot of parties and all, they will tell me, because they know I am an image consultant, I work with self-image, I work with external appearances. Oh, you might have to get ready whenever you go out and you have to be so prim and proper with people. I said, no, it's not that. If they accept me in this way, they would accept me the same way. It's not necessary that I would be sitting all dolled up every time. Why should I do that? Yes. It's up to me. If I feel comfortable without a makeup right now also, I'm very happy to be without makeup.
Yes.
So there are times where I've just walked away and I don't mind showing my flaws, my under eye circles, my skin breaking out. It's absolutely okay. It's a part of our lives and everybody goes through that phase.
Yes.
Let us remember, everybody goes through. So I'm not unique to that particular thing. So today, if you're telling me that, maybe that is going to come to you very next day. You know, that person should realize that it is for you. How can you tell me about it? So loving ourselves, accepting ourselves, treating ourselves with care, take care of your body, as I said, because you live in it. And it is giving you the confidence to walk around, to think better. So we should be surrounded by people also who give us this positivity.
Yes.
Change those people around you. Tie up with the people who give you the confidence, who appreciate you more, who tell your flaws also, but they are telling you in a right manner. They want you to come out, you know, they want you to help you. So have change your people. And I have seen that personally, the moment you change your friend circle, the moment you change your social surroundings, it plays with you.
It does.
It gives you a lot of confidence and support. It does a lot of. It's okay to leave few people on the way. It's absolutely okay to leave them.
Yeah.
Now, because this is for your growth.
Yes.
If you are wanting to grow in life, you have to leave something behind, right?
Absolutely.
So it's okay. You will find better people. You will find people who are supporting you, who are helpful, who like you the way you are. Automatically, don't we say that famous movie ka dialogue from Shah Rukh Khan's movie, you know? Aapko agar kuch karna hai, to kudrat bhi aapka saath deti hai.
Yes, jud jati
hai. Kainat, puri kainat bhi aapke saath jud jati hai agar aapko agar kuch karna hai. Similarly, when you're sending that good vibes around you, those kind of people will only be attracted towards you. Then these people will be out of your way. Because wahi hota hai, jaisa, it's like attraction. It's law of attraction, as we say, right?
I agree.
So we have to get that attraction, and we might find people with flaws, but they love themselves, so we love them also at the same time.
Yes.
So we have to change our surroundings, meet those people, have good conversations with them, healthy conversations that develop. You develop good relations with them, have a strong mind and a soul. For that, you have to, of course, you know, keep your physical health in perfection, good state. Meditation helps a lot. Thank you to the world. Thank you to everything around you. Even the people who have done bad to you, thank them, and you will feel so good about it that because of this, I am able to do this. So I thank this metro work going on in my house, around my house every day. It's like ringing in my ears. I thank every day because of that metro work. I wake up at 6 a.m. every day. Otherwise, I was unable to do that. So I thank that. Okay, that's an alarm for me that it's 6 o'clock in the morning and you have to get up. So the moment you start even accepting these kinds of things around you, you are much more happier. You don't see anything wrong that's around you.
I agree.
So you will have those people with you. So these are 2-3 things. Stop blaming. Stop complaining. Don't make excuses. Love yourself. Gratitude to the world and people around you. Positive affirmations. Acceptance and self-love. These are very important.
Yes. I think this has been such a powerhouse of a session. With everything that you have said, I have resonated with it at 1000% with every single thing that you said. Because a lot of things that, you know, we mentioned about, it comes naturally to some people and some people work on it. But I have personally seen, because a lot of the things that we spoke about have come naturally to me over a period of time, you know. And some things I have also worked on. So when everything comes together, I've seen how it has changed me as a person, how it has changed things around me also. So that's the reason why I think, you know, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you for this beautiful session. Thank you for sharing such important things that people sometimes tend to ignore and think that it's not that important. Yeah. But it's very nice today to speak about this and to be able to tell people that no, every little thing counts. It's what at the end of the day will give you that little bit of push which you've been lacking for such a long time. So thank you, Shraddha, for, you know, this, as I said in the beginning, this is such a fun session and I'm so glad we did this because we've shared so much important information with young girls, boys, or anybody at any stage of their life, you know, to be able to incorporate slowly in their life and then see what each little change brings in with it. So thank you for beautiful words of wisdom, your knowledge, and you know, this encouragement that you have given me and everybody else who has listened to this today. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you so much, and I'm so happy to be sharing all of this on this platform. It was amazing, Karishma. Thank you so much. Bye
bye.